ready? Shall I light the fire brigade?
Why are you so happy this morning?
Why? Prefer it if I'm miserable?
Well, at least you're quiet then. Is that a new outfit?
It's called a power suit.
It's called spending my inheritance.
Yeah, well, I need to look the part.
And what part's that? Sally Webster, businesswoman.
Oh, I quite like that. It's got a nice ring to it.
And you're sure all this has got nothing to do with trial of good for Frank?
There's no shame in making yourself attractive for the person you're with. And men like him don't come along every day. What time's your train?
7. I'm off for a cab now.
Frank's just texted. He'll be back soon. I'm sure he'll give you a lift to the station.
I'll get a cab.
You've had a row or something? I don't mean to interfere, but Frank's been under a lot of pressure lately, and I think it'd be really helpful if you just cut him a bit of slack. So funny.
You are a stupid woman. Do you know that?
Excuse me?
Stupid and deluded. You walk about thinking you know better than anybody else, thinking that you are better than anybody else, sticking your nose into other people's business when you're too blind to see what's going on right underneath your own.
How dare you speak to me like that?
Truth hurts, doesn't it, Sally? Well, you better get used to that feeling.
What's that supposed to mean?
You think my son cares for you, that you're somehow special to him. Well, you're not. And the fact is, I don't think you ever were.
That's not true. Frank does care about me. He's just booked a weekend for two in Paris.
Like I said, stupid and deluded.
Oh, you're just jealous. Jealous because you can't stand anybody else to be happy.
Then why don't you ask Frank who he's actually really planning to take away with him? But I'm warning you, don't come crying to me when you find out that I was right.
Something while you get on with your work, or we could get a takeaway if you're too polite to say you don't like it.
Sally, your cooking is exquisite.
Then why don't you come?
I told you, I've got too much to do.
Well, I mean, I won't disturb you. I've got things to do.
Did you not hear what I said? Look, when I'm snowed under like this, I'm best left alone, okay?
Okay.
Okay. Speak over the weekend, yeah?
Mum, I think we're just gonna go to the cinema and then we might go for a pizza or just a coffee, depending on what we want to do. She'll be back by 11, though. Are you even listening to what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
I said I'll be back by 11.
Sorry, love, I'm a bit distracted.
Oh, and what, you're dreaming about a big boardroom deal you're going to clinch with Frank? Are you going out tonight?
Do you know, I think I just might.
Leave it, they'll go away. It's someone you know they'd have rung yet. People don't just turn up without saying.
You want to bet?
Who is it?
Sally.
Poor cow's really fallen for you.
I better answer it.
Why?
Because she'll know I'm in. The lights are on, my car's out there. We don't want her getting suspicious, not now.
Wait, you could have gone to the pub.
Just give me 2 minutes. I'll get rid of her. Something wrong?
That's what I'm here to find out.
Well, I'm just having a shower, can't it wait?
No, it can't.
Hey!
Oh, dear.
So much for having to work all evening.
Sorry you had to find out like this.
How long's it been going on?
Does it matter?
We were planning a future together. Of course it matters. You said you loved me more than you'd ever loved anyone. What happened? Oh, were you just stringing me along from the start? Were you just using me till the end of the trial?
I wasn't stringing you along.
I'm off.
Okay.
If he cheated on me, he'll do it to you.
Call me.
Right, come on. I deserve some answers.
I just...
believe how stupid I've been. When were you going to tell me?
This thing with Jenny happened very quickly. Took me by surprise, to be honest.
What do you want, sympathy?
You're asking me why I didn't tell you? I'm trying to explain.
I thought we had a future. The travel agent rang about a trip to Paris and I just assumed that was for us. I was so in love with you.
I'm sorry.
I stood by you through thick and thin. I lost half my friends siding with you against Carla. I was there for you when your father died.
Which I will never forget.
And the same again at the trial every day. And for what? To be ditched when I'm no more use to you?
That's not how it was.
Oh, just selling me down the river like the other factory girls.
I did have feelings for you, Sally. Genuine ones. Things don't always work out, do they?
Especially when you planned it in advance.
I don't know what else I can say to convince you.
Well, I'd never believe another word you'd said, so I'd save your breath.
Well, there's not much else to discuss then, really, is there?
No, you're right. So I'll just go back to my normal life and smile sweetly and keep my pretty little mouth shut about what you were planning at the factory. In your dreams.
I trust this is you letting off steam.
Well, it's got you worried, whatever it is.
Hell hath no fury, eh?
Scorn is a very good way to describe how you treated me.
I would remind you of the confidentiality clause that you signed in your contract.
Would you now?
Any breach of it will result in legal action.
Oh, and you know all about the law, don't you, Frank? Who'll be holding your hand in court next time, Jenny? Or are you casting that roving eye of yours around already?
I would also remind you of the Leyden order. It was you who first suggested subcontracting. If you open your mouth, I'll tell them all it was your idea.
You really are panicking, aren't you?
They already hate your guts, Sally. They won't take much convincing. When I've finished, they'll hate you even more.
That's your threatening look. It doesn't scare me.
No. Well, maybe it should. The last woman who crossed me, she lived to regret it.
Who, Carla? Are you saying you raped her?
Of course I'm not saying that. What do you take me for?
Then what?
I'm just saying that when she tried to fight me, she bit off much more than she could chew. Be warned.
Are you sure?
He didn't love me. didn't have any feelings for me. Why do I attract men like that?
Maybe it's just men in general.
He's a liar. It's not normal.
What do you mean? What's he lied about?
Loving me. Nothing, I can't think straight.
I need to have a bath. I've got to have a bath.
Sophie? What's the matter? Why? What's happened? Is she okay? He's done what? Right, I'll be over.
Sophie, you didn't have to get your dad round.
I know, but I was just worried, Mum.
We might not have a future, Sal, but believe it or not, I still care about you. And if things have gone belly up for you, I want to know you're okay. And if some fella I don't know has turned you over like I did.
It feels worse than that.
Why? Don't make yourself scarce. What's he done, Sal? Oh, God. He didn't. Sally, tell me he didn't.
He didn't. But I wouldn't put it past him. I won't put anything past him now.
What's he done?
He dumped me. He intimidated me. He scared me. He's been seeing somebody behind my back.
Delittle.
Warned me not to cross him. He said the last woman that did that lived to regret it. Presumably. Oh, I'm so stupid.
I'll kill him.
You'll do no such thing. I don't want you to go anywhere near him, do you hear me?
I'll rip him apart with me bare hands, Sal.
I don't want anything more to do with that poor excuse of a man. Even you're worth 10 of him, and that's saying something. I won't have him drag you down to his level.
He scared you. Then maybe he needs a scare.
Kevin, please, just leave it.
Maybe we're jumping the gun here. We've not been given any official confirmation that the factory's being sold or that we're being sacked.
Oh, that's true.
We may be overreacting. Things might not be as bad as we think.
Carla signed the contract.
Yeah, so Frank owns the factory, but we don't know what he's planning to do with it.
I saw the emails. He's planning to outsource all the manufacturing and concentrate on the selling and distribution.
And when was this?
Oh, it doesn't matter. The important thing is that we come up with a plan to fight for our jobs.
No, hang on a minute. Are you saying you knew he was planning to dump us, but you kept it to yourself?
Well, I didn't know he meant it at first.
She was in bed with him. She didn't give a stuff about us.
Did you betray us, Sally?
I thought he cared about me.
We thought you cared about us.
Seems like she only cared about herself.
Look, the moment I found out about Jenny, I tried to stop Carla from signing away the factory.
What you mean is that as soon as you found out that lovely Frank Foster was two-timing you, you realised that you were for the chop and all.
Let's not turn on each other.
She ain't one of us. She's the reason we're in this mess.
You betrayed us and you betrayed Carla.
If you'd have told us straight away, we could have done something.
I didn't know it was... I didn't know!
But don't look at me. She's the one that sold us down the river.
Tell you what, I'm parched.
Shall I brew a fresh pot?
Maybe some toast?
Oh, and then there were seven.
Where's Michelle? I thought she was on our side.
Don't think anyone's on our side anymore. Look at it.
I am looking at it.
Well, you'll have to have it out with them.
Me?
Yeah, I've got to stay here and look after Simon. Where are you going?
To get my coat.
You know, we ought to get the petition up and have that television removed.
Oh. Why don't we vote with our feet and take our cushion to the bistro?
That's a good idea. Yes.
Sally, are you all right?
I should have listened to you, Rita. It's evil. Carla was right.
Look, why don't you come with us? You look as if you need a drink.
No, I can't. I can't. It's going to clear my head.
All right, love.
Hey. Aren't you a lot a bit old to be hanging around on street corners? Just off to the bistro to celebrate my birthday.
Is it a
pina colada in a beach bar worrying about my tan peeling?
I sometimes wonder what kind of world I'm bringing this baby into.
Oh, you look at that. The lights are still on.
I'll say one thing for Frank. He puts in the hours.
He's probably in there right now, drowning puppies or strangling budgies.
Do you have a very strange imagination?
About time me and Mr. Foster had a little chat.
Oh, I'm right behind you. It is about time that he heard the voice of the workers, the heartfelt cry of the common man.
Well, on the other hand, though, I mean, it is late at night, deserted factory, rapist boss.
Oi! Come on, scaredy cat! You're right. He needs to know that his selfish plans are hurting real people. We're the innocent victims. We should have our say. Tell Mr.
as well leave us a couple of rolls of that.
Oh, don't be morbid.
It's not the first dead body they've pulled out of there.
Oh, if I've known the place for Jim, so I thought twice about taking the job.
Well, have you got a job?
Sally says we're all being laid off, but now Foster's a goner, your guess is as good as mine.
No, this isn't good for business. Police cars swarming, sirens wailing.
Listen, any scene of crime officer has to buy his boiled sweets somewhere.
Oh, scene of crime officer, I don't get you.
Police, you're allowed to open, I'm not.
Really?
Well, a ton of work in there. Can't I just shut?
Well, I suppose the police have to be thorough. I mean, a man has died.
Yeah, well, don't suppose there'll be many tears shed over that one. Besides, he was killed in the factory. Why is my garage taped up?
Well, do you not have business interruption insurance?
Yeah, but the excess is crazy. I just want to open up.
Quiet.
It was Sally that found him, wasn't it?
Oh, how awful. Well, where is she now?
I couldn't believe it when you said you was down at the station.
I was going to ring your dad, but...
And then you said to me that I had to bring you a change of clothes, right?
I didn't just take my clothes. Took samples of my hair and my fingernails. And...
Treating you like a suspect. After everything that you've been through.
Have you got a few minutes, Mrs. Webster?
I've already given you a statement.
We'd like to ask you some more questions.
Do you know this is harassment?
Sophie, it's okay. Come in.
Thank you.
This ain't
frame of mind when you went to visit Mr. Foster.
I was unhappy, obviously. I've told you all this.
You worked in a relationship with him until very recently.
Yes.
Why did the relationship end?
Because I found out he was seeing somebody else.
Who?
A business associate of Frank's.
This was a shock, was it?
It was a shock for all of us. Him and Jenny Sumner were in cahoots. She was helping him take over the factory.
Sounds messy.
It was.
So he betrayed you both personally and professionally?
Yes.
So you must have been furious when you visited him.
Angry, but...
Mr. Foster suffered a head injury. Do you have any idea how that might have happened?
No. I wanted to give him a piece of my mind, not bash him over the head.
Can you tell me exactly what happened when you went into the factory?
The factory was open. I called out his name.
Go on.
There was no reply. So I went inside. And that's when I saw him. Lying at the bottom of the stairs. There was blood around his head. I thought he'd just fallen. I had no idea he was... I crouched down beside him and I lifted his head. I was praying for him to respond, to say something, but he didn't. And that's when the others arrived.
Okay.
Yes, I was angry. But there's other people with bigger axes to grind than me.
Like who?
Like
think it's pretty big of me contacting the woman he cheated on me with. Trying to be sensitive, break the news. I wish I'd never bothered him.
You phoned her up?
Yeah, if she goes round repeating what she said, D.S. Nash might as well move into our spare room.
People know you won't be capable of doing anything like this.
Yeah, no, you're right. Look, you're the one with the wild temper.
Me? I throwed you a punch. I'm not a murderer.
You were threatening to do him in, I heard you.
Yeah, lots of people threatened him. Doesn't make me a suspect. That's ridiculous.
Me, Sally. Anne?
Go away.
I know you said you wanted to be on your own, but I was worried about you.
I keep thinking about what Carla said.
What did she say? Did she upset you?
All she wants is for people to know the truth. But I'm the only one who knows the whole truth.
What's that in your hand?
Nothing.
Frank's watch. Did you find it?
I had it all along.
But that means... Oh, my God.
Did you kill Frank? It was an accident. We had a row, a terrible row.
You must tell the police you have to tell them.
No. I can't, but please, I can't tell them. This is our secret.
Sally, wait!
Oh.
you.
Quiet, please. You don't know selling that from the funeral, do you?
She was in here earlier.
All right.
But she's gone now. Apparently, Frank's mum has some sort of meltdown at the funeral. Cancelled the wake and everything. Sally's gone to check in and see if she's all right.
I see.
It's nice, though, isn't it? I mean, she doesn't have to do that.
Well, that's Sally for you.
She deserves a medal, that one.
She deserves a red feeling, more like.
Actually, I was just on my way out.
It won't take long.
You can't just barge in here like that.
What did you mean when you said I'm sorry?
I don't remember now.
Did you know he raped me?
Look, I've just come back from my son's funeral. I can't do with all this.
Yeah, well, I'm sorry, but I'm not going anywhere till I get some answers. Did you know all along?
No, of course not.
I don't believe you, Anne. I reckon you knew right from the start, didn't you? You sided with Frank and then you watched me getting persecuted in court.
No.
When all along you could have spoken
no,
up for me.
No, I didn't know. I swear it. Not until afterwards.
What are you doing here?
Come to see you, Mum.
Well, she's at Frank's.
Yeah, I know. I thought she'd be back by now.
So did I. But I'm getting a bit worried, to be honest. She said she'd be back for dinner, but that was ages ago.
We were trying to phone her.
Yeah, she didn't answer.
I'll try. I don't know why she had to go to his funeral in the first place.
Maybe because she's nicer than you.
Yeah, and more forgiving than most of us.
So how come you said nothing?
It was too late. Damage had been done.
No, it wasn't too late. You could have cleared my name. You could have put him where he belonged.
He's dead. Isn't that enough?
No, it's not, because people still think I was lying.
What do you want me to do? Put an announcement in the papers?
Yes, yes, that would be a start.
Please, will you just go now?
Well, go on and answer it.
It doesn't matter.
I can wait.
There's no one important.
See, that's weird. Because it would have come up that it was home ringing, so why she cut the call?
Well, maybe she was driving.
No, Dad, she wasn't, because she's not answered any of her calls either. What if something's happened?
That's Sally's bag. Where is she?
She left a while ago. She must have forgotten it.
And how come you pretended it was your mobile? What's going on?
Look, if it makes you feel any better, I'll go round, see if she's still there.
I only answered it because you told me to. I mean, why are you making such a big thing out of it? Here, maybe you could return it to her. And as for the bags, well, I'm going for a little break. There's nothing wrong with that, is there?
Sally.
No, I told you, she's not here!
Sally! Sal!
Can you hear me?
What have you done?
I didn't do anything!
We need an ambulance!
No! You can't ring anyone!
What, are you crazy?
I can't let you do this.
Yeah, well.
What are you doing?
And don't be stupid.
Put it down.
Whatever's happened, dear, it's all right. It's okay, we just need to get Sally to the hospital. Come on. Put the knife down. Okay. Give me the knife. And give me the knife.
Put the mobile down. All right. It's going down. What's going on here, Anne? Why have you hit Sally?
I didn't hit her.
She tripped and banged her head.
Why didn't you get an ambulance?
Because she would have told the police.
told them what?
That I killed Frank.
What?
It's all such a mess.
Okay. I just... You tell me what happened, okay? Just start from the beginning. Tell me what happened.
I went to the factory to try to talk to him again, get him to change his mind. And I heard the two of you talking. I heard what he said to you.
That he raped me?
Yes. The way he tortured you with it. It was like watching a stranger. Not my own flesh and blood. I couldn't believe the way he lied to us. I mean, all that time we supported him and all along he was just using us. I saw you run out, and then I went and confronted him. And he had the gall to try and defend himself. No remorse. No. He even dared me to go to the police. Said they'd never believe me. I looked at him. I looked at him, and all I could think of was how ill his father had been. Worried sick about seeing him go to jail for something he hadn't done, and all along. Frank as good as killed him, you know. Sam would still be here if he hadn't. I told him to take his dad's watch off and give it back. He didn't deserve to wear it. His father would be so ashamed. He refused, so I tried to get it off him and he pushed me. And he called me a silly old woman. There was a whiskey bottle on the desk. And when he turned away, I can still remember the sound of the smashing glass and then it falling. I took the watch off and I felt his wrist and I couldn't find a pulse. And it was then I realised what I'd done. I killed my own son. I didn't mean to.
I know.
I loved him so much.
I know. And I know it wasn't your fault. The police will understand that.
No, I can't. I can't go and, to the police.
And you have to.
You can't live with this.
I'll go with you. I'll explain. They will understand.
Okay,
I promise. Please just give me the knife. It's okay. It's okay. Ambulance, please. Yes, ambulance, please. It's okay.
Please, Sal, don't leave me.
How's my mum?
You see for yourself. Only don't need to whisper. hallucination she's had.
So she's not even woken up yet?
No. How are you, love?
Me, I'm fine. There's nothing wrong with me, is there? Why?
Come on, sir. You want us to stay? Go and stretch my legs.
So have they said what's the matter yet?
What's the matter with her? She's had a bang on the head.
Yeah, Dad, I know that. But they must have said something more than that.
No, not much. Why don't you say a prayer for her? I know what I've been doing. Sophie.
Hello, Sophie. I'm Dr. Renshaw.
She's going to be okay.
Well, your mother has had some trauma to the head. And you know when that happens, you sometimes get bleeding? Well, sometimes you get minor bleeding on the inside of the head, which is what's happened to your mother. Now, we hope that this will stop of its own accord.
And if it doesn't?
We might have to operate. Make a tiny hole, drain the blood off.
And when will we know?
We'll make a decision tomorrow morning. Okay. You understand?
Yeah.
It's nice to meet you, Sophie.
It's really serious, isn't it? Drilling in her head and that.
Yeah.
Dad, please don't.
It's not my fault.
No, of course it's not. Don't be stupid, Dad.
I didn't. Don't want it done. We'd still be a family. There'd be no Frank Foster. There'd be none of this. I've learned now. There's a price to pay for everything, and I'm just... I'm frightened. And I'm paying that price now.
I suppose I... at the wedding. I'm sorry. I suppose I was just upset and I just needed someone to blame.
That's what dads are for.
No. I shouldn't have. If anything, I should be thanking you that you didn't let me marry Sean.
You really mean that?
Yeah, part of me does. The sensible part.
You know, when I married your mother, I couldn't imagine life without her. I still can't. I care about her more than anything. You know that, don't you?
Yeah, of course I do.
I don't want Sally to know that as well. I want her to open her eyes so I can say it to her.
Yeah, well. And so she does, you can say it to me, can't you? Is this decision time?
Guess so.
How are we doing?
Well, you tell us. She still hasn't come round yet.
Well, she's been stable all night. Cardiovascular and neurological signs are fine. Hemodynamically, she's doing okay.
And her scan yesterday was good.
So does that mean you'll operate or what?
I don't think we'll have to do that now.
No?
Well, you can never be 100% sure with significant trauma to the brain, but...
So, how soon will we know?
Next couple of hours.
I'll be right here. Don't worry.
So will I. She's in good hands.
What, if she doesn't wake up?
She will.
What's going on, Dad? They've been there for ages.
I don't know. Be okay.
As far as we can tell, she's groggy, but there's no obvious sign of brain damage.
That's a relief. So, what happens now?
We'll keep a close watch on her. Check there's no recurrence of bleeding or swelling on the brain.
But it's looking good.
It's looking good. You can go in and see her if you want. But don't expect too much.
Okay, thank you. Hi, Mum.
Hey.
took your time waking up, didn't you?
I'll leave you in peace.
Thank you. How are you feeling? Well, we've just spoke to the doctor and she said you're going to be absolutely fine.
Anne's laptop.
Yeah. She confessed to everything once Carla had talked her down.
How long was I out?
A couple of days.
You've been so worried, Mum.
Oh, I've been such a fool.
That makes two of us.
How are you feeling?
Groggy. My head hurts.
You will for a while. But I'm glad now that the swelling from the concussion settled down.
Oh, is it all still looking good?
We'll monitor her for another 24 hours, and if it all goes well, we'll move her out of intensive care. The police need to see you, by the way.
Oh, still a suspect, surely.
I think it's just to corroborate that other woman's story. They said it wouldn't take long.
Are you up to it?
I think I can manage that.
Please, Tina.
Oh,
why do you think I'm celebrating?
Oh, has she come round?
Yep, and she's going to be fine.
Oh, that's wonderful.
She's got to stay in hospital a bit, but she's on the mend.
Oh, no, on the house, mate.
Ah, cheers.
So, can she remember what happened then?
Yeah, all bears out what Anne and Carla said. The police want to talk to her, but that's just a formality.
Oh, with a bit of luck, she can put it all behind her.
Well, let's hope so.
That's great news, Kev.
I say that calls for another drink.
You managed to eat something then?
I didn't realise how hungry I was.
Even hospital food tastes nice when you've not eaten for 2 days.
Is it too late for visitors?
Go on then. Call me if you need anything.
Oh, okay. Thanks. Kevin, tell me you'd come round. How are you feeling?
Just lucky to be alive.
I hope you don't mind me coming. It's just, I think we've got a lot to talk about, don't you? Oh, have you spoken to the police?
Well, somebody came around this afternoon. Told them everything I could remember.
Saw you with Spark out on the landing when I got round there.
Kevin said that you talked Anne down.
As best I could. I was terrified.
Me too. When I realised she'd done it. Look, I'm really sorry.
No apologies.
No, I feel terrible. I said some horrible things.
Look, Sally, you were taken in by him, as was I.
I just feel so stupid.
How do you think I feel?
I can't begin to imagine.
Look, we were both victims, weren't we?
Well, it's very big of you to see it that way.
Hey, you were the one that realised it was Anne. They would have pinned it on me if I hadn't been for that, so.
I suppose.
Thank you. I am back in charge of Underworld now, so.
Isn't it half Frank still?
40%, Sally. It's all a bit academic for now, so.
Well, good luck.
Well, the thing is, Sal, is I was wondering if you'd consider coming to work for me.
Me?
Well, only if you'd want to, obviously. I just thought you might be looking for a job.
Of course I would. I don't know what to say to you after everything I've done.
Sal, it's not a charity case. It's just I need all the good workers I can get, and you're good.
Well, if you're absolutely sure.
I wouldn't have asked otherwise.
I'd like that. Very much.
We'll put this behind us together, yeah?